Hey everyone, my name is Sushani and I'm going to talk about my motivation for writing. Actually, to be very honest, it's a really convoluted question, something which I've never really thought about, but it's really been a very important and integral part of my life. And I would have definitely a lot to say had this topic ever arose, like it's now. So it's just like your loved ones, basically. You don't talk about them all the time, but they mean a lot to you, right? So for me, similarly for me, writing is something like that, like if the analogy explains it. Writing has been a part of my life as far as I remember. It's something where I don't have to pretend to be someone else. I can just be myself. Writing has always been my comfort zone, something which makes me feel comfortable, something which makes me feel by myself. I had started learning to write even before I could walk or talk, at around the age of 3 to 4, I guess. That's what my mom said to me. So I know that sounds weird, but that's how writing was close to me as when I was young. So I really disliked. Back when I was young, I really disliked and felt uncomfortable talking to people when I was young. So writing came to me as a natural choice to freely express myself. It's sort of an emotional outlet to me. So I was always a huge introvert in comparison to my super extrovert outgoing family, since we are Bengalis. I mean, no stereotypes over here, but like, yeah. It was sort of contradictory for me in that sense. Writing has helped me grow as a person, as it has encouraged me to discuss subjects ranging from extremely personal to social and global issues. My writings is not always just as a journal entry. It can be a short story, poem, limerick, or chapters. The point is, writing is not only my strength, but the strength of many people. All of us who love the idea and the concept of reading and writing on general would have must either at some have at some point or the other written stuff from the either from the personal experiences or from others, or they may have taken it from their from other sources as well. We all must have written at some point stuff about life journey, basically stuff on life journey, which is all about childhood, college, high school grades, post college, quarter life crisis, young adult, dating life, marriage life, midlife crisis, then parenting, then retirement, grandparenting, etc. Then we have also written about our inner problems or struggles like stress, anxiety, depression, trauma, failure, and others, which we all must have faced at one point or the other, right? And others which are followed by problems like outer problems, basically, like unemployment, negative mindsets, cynical outlook towards life, career advancement, organizational issues, and etc. So we have also must have written about your dreams and aspirations as well, right? Like about writing about becoming somebody very famous or becoming successful financially or emotionally, intellectually, spiritually, in your personal as well as professional life, in dating or in a career as well. So sometimes we just want to focus our mind on mental health and ourselves, on our personal feelings and our emotional state as well. So we then at that time we have also written on stuff like which is either related to happiness or sadness. That is when how we are feeling at the moment. Then we must have like written something about mindfulness or happiness or clarity or success or inspiration or compassion, hope, faith, love, something which motivates us, basically. So writing has been always there in some form or the other, in some manner or the other, to elevate us from either a feeling or a moment. So whenever you are happy, you tend to write. Whenever you're sad, you also tend to write. It gives you, if you know, writing is a way of, even it's like writing, you know, the people who write, it's for them, it's like talking to another person without being judged. You know that you're not gonna get judged. Sometimes you just don't feel like talking to people. Sometimes you just want to be yourself. Sometimes you just want some closure, and you know, some me on one-on-one, so that you can have some time to think, so then you can jot down stuff as well. So at that point, writing helps you a lot, because it clears your mind about what all that's going in your mind. So when you are writing, it just clarifies to a large extent what your thoughts and internal processes are. So I for me, like I said, these are all motivations for my like writing, for not only me in general, so to speak, but for many people around whom I might have known or may not have known. But this is like a general perception about writing, where it just makes you happy sometimes. It's just like a feeling which cannot be explained. What sort of high, I might say, emotional high you get after writing, it can't be explained by a particular individual. It's something we all feel differently at different levels. What I feel after writing might be very different for you. So writing is a very personal and intimate experience. It differs from person to person. It's about one, it can be either about one's journey, or it can be about somebody else's journey as well. So during this pandemic, when all of us are like bogged down and frustrated about life, we can use this opportunity to write and explore ourselves and others as much as we want through writing, because it's a very creative form of art. So when you are writing, you are expressing yourself in a very unique manner. So you are also learning more about yourself. Writing helps you to do that, you know. So personally, I learned a lot more about myself through writing. So I urge all of you to write a lot during this pandemic and explore all sides of yourself. Thank you so much.